Hi everyone, welcome to the WhaleZone series. My name is Simon and I'm marine environmental scientist and guide at Terra Azul. In this episode I will answer the question, why do whales and dolphins strand? Be sure to check out the links in the description and subscribe and leave your comments below. Stranding in general means that a marine mammal died due to the beaching or died before and was floated to the beach. Stranding can be divided into two types. There is a single stranding when only one animal strands, or a mass strandings when a whole pod of animals strands. When cetaceans are stranded alive, they can die due to injuries, dehydration, collapsing under their own weight, or drown if their blowhole is covered by the high tide. There are different reasons why whales and dolphins could strand. One possibility which can lead whales and dolphins to strand are variations in the intensity of the Earth's magnetic field. Whales and, for example, migratory birds and sea turtles are using the magnetic field for orientation through long distances. Continents influence the magnetic field depending on the rocks and the chemical composition of the rocks. This might disturb the whale's navigation system and they can swim into shallow waters and strandings can occur. Furthermore, solar storms can influence the Earth's magnetic field as they cause abnormalities. In species with a very tight social bonding, it can happen that whole pods are stranding. The group might follow a leading animal which did a navigational mistake, or the group follows one sick or wounded animal which leads the whole pod onto shore. There are also human influences that can cause strandings in cetacean, like for example seismic surveys. These loud sounds can cause behavioral responses which lead to physiological responses and let whales and dolphins strand. Some species, like for example bottlenose dolphins and orcas, are using strand feeding as a technique to catch their prey. For this, they are stranding themselves on beaches to catch a seal or a single fish. These intentional strandings risk that they are not able to get into the water again. We cannot protect the whales and dolphins if the strandings have natural origin. But if they are caused by humans, we should try our best to reduce the noise pollution and to follow guidelines for seismic explorations. It is important to perform autopsies on dead animals to find out why they stranded. See you next time in our next WhaleZone series. Bye!